I will discuss over millimeter wave, which is also known as. So it is important that you stay connected with me to the last of the video, and if you are watching this video on YouTube, please click on the red subscribe button and bell button to enable the email notification. If watching this video on Facebook, then please click to like and follow the page. Now I will discuss over millimeter wave, which is also known as extremely high frequency. Yeah, very high frequency. Frequency range ki baat kare to millimeter wave is the band of a spectrum between 30 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. Here formula is lambda equal to C by F. Lambda is the wavelength, F is the frequency. One question comes here. Why its name is millimeter wave? Radio signals are measured by their wavelength. The shorter the wavelength, higher the frequency, because lambda equal to C by F, where lambda is wavelength and F is frequency. That means wavelength is inversely proportional to the frequency. If frequency is higher, wavelength will be smaller. Here I have told millimeter wave is the band of a spectrum between 30 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. If you will convert 30 gigahertz in millimeter wave, then it is equal to approximately 10 millimeter. And if you will convert 300 gigahertz in millimeter, then it is equal to approximately 1 millimeter. That means millimeter wave have short wavelength that range from 10 millimeter to 1 millimeter. 5G signal will use wavelength that are measured in millimeter. That's why 5G is considered millimeter wave technology. Two type of frequency range is defined in 3GPP. First one is the sub 6 GHz range is called FR1, and millimeter wave range is called FR2. Already I have discussed in last slide some subcarrier spacing, that means 15 kHz and 30 kHz, which is used only in sub 6 GHz, that means FR1, and some subcarrier spacing like 120 kHz can be used in millimeter wave range, that means FR2, and some subcarrier spacing like 60 kHz can be used both sub 6 GHz and millimeter wave range. जो 60 kHz वो दोनों में यूज होता है, sub 6 GHz and millimeter wave range दोनों के लिए यूज होता है. That means 60 GHz will use for both FR1 and FR2. इसका मतलब ये है कि 53 जो है kHz है, that it will use for the FR1 होगा, and 120 kHz है जो millimeter के लिए है, वो millimeter के लिए यूज होगा, and 60 kHz जो है वो आपका सब 6 GHz एंड मिलीमीटर वेव दोनों के लिए यूज होगा. यहाँ पे अगर हम चैनल बैंडविड्थ की बात करें तो इट इज़ कैलकुलेटेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ नंबर ऑफ RB, नंबर ऑफ सब कैरियर स्पेसिंग एंड गार्ड बैंड. इफ वी टॉक अबाउट 60 MHz, देन इट इज़ डिवाइडेड इन सम पार्ट, दैट टोटल 60 MHz, वेयर सम पार्ट इज फॉर ट्रांसमिशन बैंडविड्थ, where all the data is transmitted and some part will be used as a guard band. In LTE, we know that 20 MHz total number of resource block is 100 resource block for 20 MHz. But in 5G, total number of subcarrier spacing is 15 kHz, 30 kHz, 60 kHz and 120, like that. But in LTE, only one subcarrier spacing was used. It is 15 kHz. In LTE, total number of 100 RB is used for 20 MHz, and for 10 MHz, total number of RB is 50. But in 5G, for different subcarrier spacing like 50, 30, 60, there are different RB is used. Here we can see for 5 MHz, number of RB is 25 resource block, 25 RB is used, and for 20 MHz, and for 20 MHz total number of resource block is 106 resource block. Now if talk about 60 kHz subcarrier spacing and their bandwidth is 60 MHz, then number of resource block is 79 resource block is used. अगर सब कैरियर स्पेसिंग साइज 15 kHz है और बैंडविथ 20 MHz है, देन टोटल रिसोर्स ब्लॉक जो होगा वो 106 रिसोर्स ब्लॉक होगा। लेकिन अगर सब कैरियर स्पेसिंग साइज जो है वो 60 kHz है और बैंडविथ जो है 60 MHz है, देन टोटल रिसोर्स ब्लॉक जो होगा वो 79 रिसोर्स ब्लॉक होगा। दिस इज चार्ट एज पर 3GPP। इफ वी विल टॉक अबाउट द गार्ड बैंड, it is also calculated, it is also defined in 3GPP. There is a different type of subcarrier spacing like 50, 30, 60 kHz. For different bandwidth, size of guard band is different. Suppose that if we are talking about the subcarrier spacing is 60 kHz and bandwidth is 60 MHz, then guard band size will be 1530 kHz. Here we can see the example of subcarrier spacing. There is a 60 kHz and their bandwidth is 60 MHz. For this, number of RB is 79 and number of subcarrier is 12. Number of subcarrier is same for all subcarrier spacing. For all type of subcarrier spacing like 50, 30, 60 kHz, their number of subcarrier is same, 12. So here we can see for the 60 kHz and 60 MHz is 79 into 12 into 60, that means 56,880 kHz, that means approx 56.8 MHz. If we talk about the guard band, then both side guard band is here. So guard band for 60 kHz and guard band will be 50-30 kHz multiplied by 2, because guard band is both side. So 50-30 into 2, that means 3060 kHz, that means 3.06 MHz. If we add both A plus B, then it is approx 59.94 MHz, which is close to 60 MHz. As per previous slide, millimeter wave have short wavelength that range from 10 mm to 1 mm. They have high atmospheric attenuations and are absorbed by gases in atmosphere, which reduce the range and the strength of the wave. Rain and humidity can impact the performance and reduce the signal strength. Due to short range, about less than kilometer, millimeter wave travel by line of sight. So its high frequency wavelength can be blocked by physical object like building and tree. A possible approach to solving the blockage effect is through the higher density infrastructure and relay. Relay is like a repeater. The base station and relay are densely deployed in outdoor urban area for millimeter wave communications. Basically, transmitter is transmitting beam toward the destination user, but it is blocked by some cluster or building. In this situation, transmitter will look for nearby base stations or relay for user, which can have loss link, that means line of sight link, with destination user. Iska matlab ye hai ki transmitter ya macro cell is transmitting something in beam form, but wo block ho raha hai due to the some cluster ya building. Is situation mein macro cell ko check karta hai ki us user ke nearby mein base station kaun sa hai ya koi small cell kaun sa hai, जिसके साथ वो लाइन ऑफ साइट लिंक एस्टेब्लिश कर सके, और फिर ट्रांसमीटर ट्रांसमिट द बीम टुवर्ड द स्मॉल सेल या रिले। अगर हम ओवरऑल फ्रीक्वेंसी डिजाइन की बात करें तो इसमें लोअर फ्रीक्वेंसी बैंड एंड हायर फ्रीक्वेंसी बैंड दोनों इन्वॉल्व होता है। लोअर फ्रीक्वेंसी बैंड रेंज इज हायर, सो मोस्टली इट विल यूज फॉर मैक्रो सेल, एंड हायर फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज इज फॉर अ स्मॉल एरिया, सो इट विल यूज फॉर द स्मॉल सेल। एज एग्जाम्पल, if we are using 3 GHz and 60 GHz frequency, in that situation 3 GHz cellular band are used in wide area for macro cell to provide the blanket coverage and mobility, while higher frequency band like 60 GHz such as millimeter wave band will be used in a small area for a small cell to provide higher capacity. यहाँ पे कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर है। अगर लो फ्रीक्वेंसी है तो ये लार्ज एरिया को कवर करेगा, और अगर हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी है तो लो एरिया को कवर करेगा। कंट्रोल प्लेन एंड यूजर प्लेन फॉर अ स्मॉल सेल आर सेपरेटेड। यहाँ कंट्रोल इन्फॉर्मेशन जो है वो कंट्रोल होगा मैक्रो सेल से, बिकॉज मैक्रो सेल यूजिंग द लो फ्रीक्वेंसी मीन्स हायर रेंज विल यूज। एंड डाटा ट्रांसमिशन के लिए हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी या बोले तो मिलीमीटर वेव फ्रीक्वेंसी यूज करेगा, बिकॉज इट्स रेंज इज अ स्मॉल एरिया बट कैपेसिटी इज हाई, बिकॉज अ स्मॉल सेल विल यूज फुल फ्रीक्वेंसी बैंडविड्थ फॉर यूजर प्लेन। नाउ मासिव MIMO, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज कम्स Why massive MIMO?
And also I am working with another topic of 5G and LTE in depth. So please हमारे चैनल से जुड़े रहें। अगर आप इस वीडियो को YouTube पे देख रहे हैं और मेरे चैनल पे नए हैं तो इसे सब्सक्राइब कर लें और इसके बगल में एक बेल बटन होगा उस पर क्लिक करके ईमेल नोटिफिकेशन को इनेबल कर लें। अगर इस वीडियो को Facebook पर देख रहे हैं तो प्लीज़ पेज को लाइक एंड फॉलो कर लें। अगर आपको कोई क्यूरी है तो नीचे कमेंट बॉक्स में कमेंट करें। अगर आपको वीडियो पसंद आया है तो प्लीज़ लाइक कर लें। सो थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो। बाय, टेक केयर।